Greetings. Brother Ahmed, I want to just share my heart with you. I understand you are committed to believing Muhammad. Muhammad said he was a prophet. And because you want to honor God, you try to honor a man who claimed to speak for God. I respect your sincerity, brother, even as I know you are sincerely wrong. Jews and Christians believe the prophets. Christians believe what Jesus said. And the things Jesus said cause us to believe Jesus is God. Prophet David said the following in the Psalms. Psalms 110, verse 1. A psalm of David. The Lord, the Hebrew is Yahweh, says to my Lord Adonai. Notice, God is speaking to Adonai, which can also mean God. For example, brother, to say the Shema, Jews use Adonai for Yahweh. The Shema comes from Deuteronomy. In the English, Deuteronomy 6:4, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. But in the Hebrew, here is what it says. Shema Yisrael, Yahweh Eloheinu, Yahweh Echad. I bet if you've heard it, it sounds a little different. Think about it, and the Shema sounds like the following. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Out of respect for the name of God, they substitute Adonai for Yahweh, because Adonai is still a term used only for God. That is why Psalms 110 verse 1 caused Jewish leaders some confusion. Psalm 110 1, a psalm of David, the Lord says to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. Essentially, the Lord said to my God. Just how does a rigidly stilted monotheism handle God talking to another God like himself? This is one of those verses, brother, where God revealed the Trinity. God spoke through Prophet David to say something that only the Trinity could explain. First, Jesus confounded the Jewish leaders with this verse. Matthew 22, verse 42. What do you think about the Christ, Messiah? Whose son is he? David's, they answered. You think Jesus is the Messiah, right? So here, Jesus is talking indirectly about himself, Messiah. He says to them, how then does David in spirit call him, meaning the Messiah, Lord? How does David call Messiah God? Saying, the Lord, Kyrios, said to my Lord, Kyrio, sit at my right hand until I place your enemies as a footstool for your feet. See, Jesus is quoting Psalms 110, verse 1. Notice what Jesus and Prophet David say happens. The enemies of Messiah will be made footstools. The enemies of Messiah will be forced beneath his feet, under his shoes. So this is what Prophet David proclaimed for Messiah over his enemies. And Jesus claimed this verse about himself. Matthew 26:64. You have said so, Jesus replied, but I say to all of you, from now on you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One, and coming on the clouds of heaven. Jesus said he would be seated at God's right hand. That should not be too hard for you to understand, brother. You agree Jesus is the Messiah. Sadly, Islam does not believe what Prophet David said about Messiah. The disciples believed the prophets, brother, including Prophet David. Acts 2:33, "Therefore, having been exalted at the right hand of God, and having received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father, he has poured out this, which you are both seeing and hearing. For David did not ascend into heaven, but he himself says, 'The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand, until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet.'" He's talking of Messiah, Jesus. The disciples knew the Messiah was also Adonai, Lord, God. The disciples believed the prophets, and it taught them Jesus is Adonai, Lord, God. Who is it that wants to stop you from believing the prophets, brother? Satan wants to stop you from believing the prophets. If you want to believe the prophets, brother, cry out to God. Cry out to God for the truth about Messiah. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Messiah, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.